who are just kind of overwhelmed when they first hear this knowledge, you know, what I found useful in my practice is I ask them to start kind of crowding out less healthy foods in the diet by adding. I say, look, you know, I want you to eat, you know, this much fruit every day. I want you to have a salad every day. I want you to have, you know, and kind of go through these simple steps. So first, they don't feel like they're depriving. In fact, I'm asking them to eat more food all of a sudden. And I don't say replace it. I just say there's only so much food, you know, space we have in our stomach. There's only so many calories that we, you know, tend to equilibrate throughout the day. And so by slowly adding more and more of these healthy foods, first, their palate is changing, getting to like healthier foods better. They're discovering new things. I never knew hummus existed. Wow, this stuff is great, you know. And going through, and then so they're finding out new stuff that they'd never experienced before. So it's kind of a exploration and discovery. They don't feel deprived, and then maybe they'll start feeling better. All of a sudden, the digestion is better, their energy is better, their sleep's better, right? And they start noticing these things, and they get more and more, you know, healthy. And then, you know, nothing tastes as good as healthy feels. I mean, once people realize, and people can say, "Oh yeah, I feel fine," but we're actually constipated, and yeah, of course, they have hemorrhoids, but everyone has, you know, and they have all the, yeah, dyspepsia and heartburn. Yeah, everybody. I mean, this is, look, I see ads on TV all the time. I mean, people just assume that's health. I mean, like, look, I'm going to work, I'm, you know. But then, once they know true health, once they get up in the morning and they're just like, they're ready to go, I mean, that's a different experience for a lot of people. And they say, wow. Maybe it's normal to actually feel great, right? Maybe it's normal to have all this energy. And really, I mean, you know, maybe it's normal not to get sick all the time and not to have these allergies and these joint aches and these, I mean, then, you know, people don't want to go back. I mean, you couldn't pay them to go back. In fact, there's these studies, these series of studies, they do what are called crossover studies, these dietary trials. It's very different, difficult to, you can't randomize people, right? In drug trials, you give people a sugar pill versus your pill, and so you can randomize people. But people tend to know if you try to make them eat broccoli or something, right? You can't make a placebo broccoli. So you say, okay, well, how are we sure that diet, you know, if we change people's diet and they feel better, you know, how do we, maybe they would have felt better anyway. So what they do is they do a crossover study where they take people, they switch them to a healthy diet, and they record the symptoms before and after that change, and then they have them switch back to the original, the baseline diet, or call it ABA study design or crossover study. And so migraine studies, take people with migraines, put them on a plant-based diet, and then migraines go away, and then just to make sure that's what did it, put them back on the baseline diet, migraines back. Okay, so then you know. But the problem, interestingly, when these studies have been done, is that many patients refuse to go back, even though they signed something saying, yes, I'll do this. They signed up, then in many cases got paid to participate in the study. And what actually ends up happening is you have to throw that study participant out in terms of the data. You can't use that data because they didn't complete the study, right? And so actually, the diet can be so effective, it actually undermines the ability to show how effective it is because people just won't go back. I mean, because they just didn't know. They could feel this good, and they've done that with, you know, menstrual pain. They've done that with, you know, arthritis. They've done that with a lot of the inflammation and pain syndromes, as well as the more serious diseases. But, you know, within a few weeks, you can see some of these dramatic changes, and that's, you know, that's and but it does take a few weeks, right? I mean, so that's why, you know, I basically tell people to think of it as like a free sample. Right. Take a look. Let's as an experiment. Give me 3 weeks. Change it. Look, anyone can eat anything for 3 weeks. Right. In fact, you can eat nothing for 3 weeks. I mean, you know, and so because people can't wrap their heads around, I'm never going to have another pepperoni pizza again ever. Like that's just like, okay, I can't even do anything. Right. But you're like, okay, look, in 22 days, back to pepperoni pizza, whatever you want to do. But give me 21 days. But all the way, you know, dive in. Right. We're going to do your blood work now, we're going to do your weight, we're going to, you know, okay. And then, you know, and the first few days, it's, you know, they don't know what to eat when they go, you know, they're at work, what are they going to get for lunch? And there's, you know, maybe, you know, social situations or within their family, there's some friction. Once they kind of get the hang of it, and their taste buds start to change, their palate starts to change, things start tasting, but natural foods start tasting better. Then once they start feeling the differences, and again, it just takes a few weeks, then you got them, right? I mean, then they're, You know, but again, if they wouldn't have even started if this was like, this is going to be for the rest of your life. And so that kind of just to say, look, let's just give it a try. Why not? Just, you know, humor me for a few weeks. And that's often what does it. And you see these remarkable blood. You know, I say, okay, remember how I was going to put you on diabetes medication? We don't do that anymore. In fact, you know, the cholesterol medication you're on now, we're going to stop it because you're risking side effects for nothing. It's not doing you any good because your blood levels are so good. You know, I mean, people love that. People don't understand what diabetes means. Diabetes is the number one cause of adult onset blindness, the number one cause of amputations, the number one cause of kidney failure. People go on dialysis, have a few years to live. I mean, blindness, losing a limb. I mean, this is really, I mean, that's what diabetes means. And it's a disease that's completely, type 2 diabetes, completely preventable, and we can stop it, we can reverse it. People who've had diabetes for decades on insulin can be insulin-free, all medication-free within a matter of weeks, in some cases, with a healthy enough diet. I mean, and if that isn't a testament to the power of plans, you know, what is? I say there's only one diet that's ever been proven to reverse heart disease in the majority of patients, and that's a plant-based diet. Right? Anytime anyone comes to you with a fancy new diet, ask them, do me a favor, ask them this one question. Does it reverse the heart disease number one killer, number one reason you and all your loved ones will die? If the answer is no, why would you even consider it? Right? And if that's all a plant-based diet can do, reverse our number one killer, well then shouldn't that be the default diet until proven otherwise? And the fact that it also been shown to, you know, prevent, treat, and reverse other leading killers like hypertension and type 2 diabetes would seem to make the case just overwhelming for eating a whole food plant-based diet.